It's same as Git, except that it has a different schema. So instead of Git, you have the HTTP. You see? It's same like here.
But you have the Git in the beginning also.
Yes, but instead of Git, use HTTP.
And the Git at the beginning of the name. Git dot
Git. Yes, and instead of Git, use HTTP prefix. Except that with HTTP you cannot use the argument, oops, the depth one, so it will check out.
Can you again show the command line to load the package?
I can modify this one, so you can.
No, before to load the package for power.
Ah. Wait. So, this one, yeah? Site for Gitorius?
Yeah.
Gitorius.org.
.org, okay. What do you search for when you're in there?
I will show you. So you go to gitorius.org/cogvm and you can navigate from there to my repository.
Okay,
so here you can find the seek cog, which is my branch of this project. And so here you already have the URL for checking out the code, and pressing the asterisk you can find the instruction for how to clone the repository like here. It takes a while to clone whole repository because It's big. But we will get to that after. Which one? This? You can ask Jean-Baptiste for help. Okay, so I will continue with slides, and then once we're done with the material, we will build the VM. So this section about C code generators, this is a part of VMmaker. And it's response the main class which is responsible for translating Smalltalk Slang to C code, which is then compiled and built in VM. So it, there is a main class which is a C code generator and two subclasses. So I will mainly I will talk about C code generator because it's basis for VM generation, and others too is mainly for plugin code generator. So here's a simple example of code which of Smalltalk code which you want to generate. You want to translate this class to C code, and using a C code generator with expression like that, it I can tell you that this is not the full source. There is some helper methods which you need to implement at class side to make this expression work, because there are some queries from code generator how to generate code and what to do and things like that. But in nutshell, this is done like that. So you pass in the class name and say, telling code generator to generate C file and with doing lining, and then it generates the file which looks similar, looks like this. So it has a header that tells that it's automatically generated code. Then it has sections, which is constants, function declarations, variables, and actually actual function implementation. So you, if you can see, here's the two methods which translated to C code, which is foo and value. And here how they look in Smalltalk code, and here how they look in C code. So in nutshell, it's works. It's quite simple way to translate, but of course there is some tricks and some special directives, and we will get to this in detail. So the, in basically all message sends which you put in the code is translated to function calls. So for instance, if you have a expression like z equals l foo bar, then it translates to expression to C expression z equals foo bar xy. For binary and arithmetic expressions, they are converted closely to their C equivalent. So they are not called like functions, like not converted to function calls, but converted to expression to arithmetic expressions or pointer expressions. Okay, control flow is also handled specifically. So for instance, if you can see that if true if false message is translated to C trinary expression which takes three arguments, and also loops using the C while control flow statement. And same for for loops and things like that. So basically it's quite simple way to translate code, but it's good enough for most of the cases. I mean that you could actually produce the code which Smalltalk code which cannot be translated directly to C code, but in most cases, I mean, you have to follow some discipline to not allow like passing the block closure into function, because it cannot be translated directly to C code. But for most of the cases you could work around that. So that's why we talking, we saying that this is not Smalltalk, it's a Slang, because it's not features all the Smalltalk semantics, but only concrete one. So how code generator translating instance variables? For every instance variable included in class, it puts the corresponding variable in the body of your file at the global module scope. So if we go back here, you see that sqint value is put on the global scope of this C file. For class and pool variables, they work as a constants. So you're defining the class variable, then initializing it with some value before translating the code, and then after translation, it puts the definition of class variable in the body of your C file. So then you can use in places where you're using it, it puts the defined the class var identifier.
Igor?
Yes?
You said that the instance variable were put in the global...
Yes, this is special case only for interpreter.
But can I say that some way that I want to declare the instance variable inside that function and not in the global?
No. There is no way to.
Deal with name collisions or something like that.
There is no way to specify that. So it means that for interpreter there's only. Is based on subclass which determines how to generate the code which declares all the instance variables. But you cannot control that in Slang.
Okay.
It's controlled by code generator.
Okay.
So also, since we're dealing with C, sometimes you need to define the custom types for your variables. And there is a special directives for doing that. So here you see the special pragma which var type. So for here for temporary variable x, you define the type void star. And during code generation, it generates the declaration with your type. Also for return type, there is a special pragma for defining the function return type, which is return type C. So, it's okay. And the ultimate one is declaration. So you put in the whole declaration of variable, and you can actually use a initializer there, so it just takes the string you put there and placing in the source code.
It's redundant with the Smalltalk code. If I do the assignment in Smalltalk, it will the result will be the same.
No.
Except the declaration in one line and the resolution.
Yes, you can put the if you later put like x equal something else, then you have declaration with initializer, and then you have x equal something. But the specific of C code is that sometimes you have to make an initialization, because you might in some situations you have to be sure that your variable is initialized before anything. Yes, and for defining the custom types or custom declarations for instance variables, at class side you should use the declare c vars in method, and you telling the code generator to use the specific type for given typed var, for given variable. So if you define the instance variable typed var, then you can tell in this method you can tell code generator to use given type for declaration of your instance variable, because by default all instance variables have type sqint if you don't use different one.
Which is at the end int or sqint?
Sqint.
Yes, it is a redefinition of some type.
Yes, it's a squeak local integer, or sqint is used for instance for all pointer types, and you have special macros which take the pointer and load the memory at its location and things like that. But sqint is the basic type which used almost everywhere in generated code.
Then if you have accessors to an instance variable, is the type inferred or should be declared
no.
by hand?
There is no accessors to instance variables.
No, I should never use
you have the instance variable declared at global scope. And whenever you use it in code, it just refers to this global. So you just put the identifier to this variable.
Yes, I understood this, but my question is that imagine in my class I put accessors.
Yes.
I should still put the type of the parameter of the right accessor.
Of return value.
The return value.
Yes.
Of the read accessor.
Yes. It not infers. I mean that if you mess with types, you have either warning at compile time or a syntax error. So. During compilation and when you've written the code, you have to keep an eye on it. And yes, and the last and most powerful thing about code generation that it can do proper inlining. So here's an example of inlined code. The inlined buggy code is a have special directive inline true, which tells the code generator to enable inlining for this method and actually inline it whenever it's possible. So there are some special cases which I don't want to mention when inlining is not possible, even if you put the inline directive. But for most of the cases, it works like that. You declaring that this method should be always inlined, and then in some method which uses this guy, you just put a message sent, and then code generator produce the code with inline. So as you can see, if you translate this in mind, this very simple example, so you send 10 and to inlined buggy with argument 10, and then inlined buggy returns an argument plus 5. So if you inline that code, you have return 10 plus 5. It's easy. I can give you some more examples. So the summary, it's not very complex. I mean that of course you need to learn this gradually, but it's mostly you just do some experimenting and just by looking at generated code you will figure out how to make it properly. So it's hard because it's there is a lot of various tricks, and it's hard to it will take a lot of time to explain all of them. And of course if it's not convincing you or not very good for you, you can always go to the code generator and improve it and change it, and yes, and let others to use it. Of course, when you're generating code like that, the C compiler is the first guy who will check if there are some problems with your code, with your generated code, and it's quite helpful. So for most of the cases, when you pass in the compilation, it means that probably your code will work. But of course, for runtime, for bugs at runtime, you are on your own. You have to use C debugger. But that's the same for any other C project, C-based application. Yes. So should I show you some examples of translation? If you want, just tell me what you want to see. We will go to that. No questions. Okay. Yes, let's compile VM. So here what we need to have. Yes. Which repository?
At Gitorius.
This one we failed to get to the
repository. So it says that
it says fetch failed.
Yes, it says because.
Because?
I can show you.
It worked with SSH.
With SSH?
The key in the Gitorius.
I've
signed.
For me, it worked without
it, but it took some minutes. What did you take?
Which repository?
Http.
Git.gitorius?
Yes.
It crashed for me after
15
minutes.
What? Git crashed? Yeah, the problem is Wi-Fi here, that they give you only 80 port open, but not HTTPS.
You're missing a git dot Gitorius.
Here, yes.
Uh-huh.
Okay, yeah. So if you see it, don't supports depth. I put the depth here because if you don't have the depth, it will download the whole repository, which takes much longer. But it should work. Yeah, maybe it will be faster to zip the already cloned repository. because it can take ages. Can you see my computer in the local network?
No.
Okay, then I can use the key, the USB. Yeah, it appears that HTTP colon has some problems. Yes, one thing which you also can do is to register at Gitorius, so you obtain your own login there, and you can use the clone repository button here to make own private clone of this repository, and then check out the code from your own repository. Okay, here the USB with source code.
I have it on Dropbox.
Okay, so give me the link.
send it to the family.
Yes. No, still no mail. this one?
Yeah.
So what is it? Skik file?
No. It's
So here, yes? Okay. So download this one if you have problems with Git.
Igor?
Yes?
Download it and check it.
Okay. Thank you.